shoulder back and down, so you get this stretch there. This shoulder doesn't come up, it stays low, but you just squeeze the chest. You don't want to be going like this.
You don't want that.
You want to be lifting it right over like that. Right up like that. Now the chest pops out.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do with Ben today is we're going to run through this first posing session. It's just going to be a quick introduction to the main compulsory poses he's going to have to go through on stage. He's going to then go away, practice these, tweak these, and come back week by week, and we're going to practice this on a weekly basis, and he's going to show me his improvements. Okay, so Ben, what we're going to do today is we're just going to run through your posing. Now, it's 8 weeks out to your show, roughly, 7.5, 8 weeks. Posing is such a critical part of bodybuilding. A lot of people leave it right to the end before they practice, before they get good at it. But if you make it early on as possible in your bodybuilding journey, you're going to get many benefits from it. Posing will create more muscle separation. It will help volumize the muscle. It will help burn body fat. Okay, so it's not just about posing better, but also when you get to the day of the show, there's no mirrors. You're on stage, so when you hit your poses,
right,
you want to make sure that you unconsciously are confident that you're hitting them perfectly.
Yeah.
Because somebody can come on and they might not be as ripped as you, they might not even be as big as you, they might not look as good as you, but if they pose perfectly and they can show what they've got so much better than you can, they're going to beat you.
Right.
Okay, so posing is massively important. Right. So what we're going to do today is we're going to run through the compulsory poses that the judges are going to ask you to do. We're going to make small tweaks here and there, and then over the next few weeks we're going to keep on improving and improving and improving.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's get started with the first few poses that you're going to have to learn.
Right. Okay, cool.
First pose, front double bicep. Okay. So I think you've been practicing your bicep pose. So you've learned how to accentuate your bicep.
Yeah.
So again, first thing you practice is putting your toes out, tensing your quads, squeezing into your double bicep pose, remembering to bring the lats out as much as possible, yeah, and breathing your stomach in. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's good. Just tense your quads. Yes. Now this is the thing, people forget to tense the legs. The more you practice, you're going to have to keep reminding yourself to tense your legs, which is why I say front double biceps, first things I do is tense your quads, then into the pose.
Right.
Yeah?
So tense your quads first.
Yeah.
So soft at the knees just to get them flaring a bit.
Yeah. Good. Good. That's good.
Right.
It's complete side profile. So you're looking at the body from the side, yeah? What we can do here is bring our shoulder back and drop it down a bit. What you want to remember is that posing is a form of contortion. You're bringing your body into positions to exaggerate how the muscles look intense, just so that they look their best.
Right.
So to begin with, posing is not going to feel natural. It's going to feel like a very unnatural thing to do.
Yeah.
Okay. This is why we've got to practice, 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 so that when you're on stage, the poses are natural. Make sense?
Yeah.
So you come up, stand in line, you're all like this, you're holding yourself in the position where you, that's it. Yeah, what you want to be careful at the moment, you're twisting your whole body around too much.
Okay.
When it's just your shoulder.
Okay.
And your chin, that's better. What you're going to have to practice is bringing this shoulder back and down.
Yeah.
And that's part of the contortion, because to do that is very unnatural. But if you bring that back and down, the whole chest looks a lot fuller. Remember, this is called a side chest because that's what they're judging.
Yeah.
So you want your upper and lower chest need to look balanced, middle chest needs to look full, this chest needs to look developed on the bottom here, and full as well. So what you're doing everything you can to make that chest look big. Then you're breathing in here tight with the waist, sticking your rib cage out, and already there's a huge difference between your upper and lower body.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
Is that better?
That's much better. That's much better. That's an Arnold side chest.
Oh, yeah. I think I prefer that.
So this is all about, is so you can go home and have a little play around.
Right.
Go, oh yeah, that looks better like that, that looks better like that. Oh yeah, this chest looks better like that.
Right.
You need to really tweak it and tailor it to your physique and bring out the best in it, and then come back and then we'll have a look at what you've done. Now, rear lat spread. From the front, you want to be putting your hands here on the bottom of your back, okay, pushing against your thumbs, pulling your shoulders wide, okay?
Yeah.
But also, what you're doing, think of a cobra flaring out and down. So what I'm doing with my lats, I'm actually pulling them wide, but I'm also pulling them out and down. So if you look at me from the side now, where I do a lat pose, tense your legs.
So you're leaning back.
I'm leaning right back. Okay, this is what you don't see from the front.
Right.
From the front, you don't see them leaning back. You just see the lats come out. But by leaning back, you kind of bring out the lats. Okay?
Yeah.
With the lats spread, you're not really contracting the lats so much as you are spreading them, as you are stretching them, then you tense them. So it's the only pose, like tricep peak contraction, easy, you can feel it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Abs, you can crunch it, you can feel it. Quads, you can tense it in peak contraction, you can feel it. Lats, you're stretching and then tensing.
Yeah.
You're not bringing it into peak contraction. Like all other muscle groups to pose.
So stretch them into position and then you tense.
That's it.
Right.
So you don't want to be like trying to tense your lats and then trying to bring out, because you won't, because they'll be pulling in.
Yeah.
So bring your wrists that way.
Oh, right.
But down, bring them right down, really twist down. That's it. Now you can see peak on your bicep, peak on your shoulder. You'll be tensing your delts, bringing those together. You'll be squeezing all in the back here and stretching your lats at the same time, as well as putting one foot back, tensing your calf, tensing your hand. That leg there needs to be back
further.
Yeah.
Oh wait.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But again, we really need to practice that one. Remember, you're doing first timers or novice categories. These people have very little experience.
Yeah.
So if you can outgun them on posing, and you come on and you're really confident, you're posing correctly, you're going to stand out.
Right.
The judge is going to look at you and go, wow, he doesn't look like he's not done this before.
So regardless of the physique, you can do yourself a lot of favours by being good at the posing.
Absolutely, man.
Yeah.
Some people, I used to do this for rear tricep, for tricep, pull the chest over, and just do that with one arm, push one arm down.
Oh, right.
But you do get a slight increase in size if you can pull against your hand, which is why that one's used by most.
Oh, I see.
Abs and thighs. The idea is to pull your toe up. You pick one thigh to tense, lean back on the other one. Still tense that one and flare it out.
Yeah.
This one, you bring your toe up and you'll twist it to the side so you can get that maximum width and definition on your quad.
Really?
And then arms behind your head. And if you can imagine, you're trying to tense all the way up here.
Yeah.
So you would tense and then crunch. Again, that's going to take a lot of practice.
Yeah.
When you do an ab crunch, you want to get a slight twist in your pose, just so you can get the intercostals coming in.
Oh, so I see. So I'm going to go that way and twist that way slightly.
Yeah. Most muscular.
Yeah.
Different types of most muscular pose. Some people, again, legs start those first, flare them out, push down, squeeze your quads. Some people will bring their shoulders over, put their hands together, and do that one. Okay, trying to bring the shoulders, traps, and obviously squeezing the chest.
They're trying to make the delts pop out.
If someone's got predominantly big delts, this would be a really good pose for most muscular.
Okay.
It would really make their delts and traps stand out, yeah? Then you've got some bodybuilders, again, if they've got huge delts and traps and not such a big upper chest, they will lean right over, okay, like this. Or you've got the classic way, which is exaggerating the chest a little bit more, which is what I prefer, which is where you bring your arms back, okay, get that stretch on the chest, drop your shoulders down, and then bring your arms up and through. And with that pose, you can really exaggerate the chest popping out.
And the shoulders are coming over the chest.
The shoulders, you don't want the shoulders coming over like this, you want to bring them down and bring them from underneath. That's what pops the chest out.
Oh, I see.
See, from the side, the chest should be popping out that way. If it's not, it's because your shoulders are right over.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Okay.
But again, your own physique, everyone has their slight change to their physique, bring out the maximum from your body.
I think
that looks good, man. That looks good.
I think I'm...
Yeah.
Yeah, that was good for your physique, man.
Yeah, I think I'd prefer that upright one.
Yeah. Yeah.
I gotta get a little legs.
Yeah.
Obviously breathing your abs in as well. Now flare your quads up, tense your quads. Yeah, that's it. Good. 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 When you get ready for a bodybuilding show, obviously you're going to be on stage and it's all about posing and showing off your physique, but very often people underestimate or forget how important posing is. Now posing isn't just for bodybuilders stepping on stage, posing is for anybody that really wants to develop their physique. Posing actually brings out muscle separation, brings out definition in the muscle. It's great for fat loss, it's great for muscle volumization, and it's great for mind-muscle connection. And it can really make the make or break of a physique. In the gym, you might see people that are well built, but they just don't have that cut, that definition, that quality that someone else will have. I can guarantee you, the guy with the best physique and the best definition, the best separation, he will have been a master at posing.